Maybe you've wondered, why do I need someone else to host my websites on a server? I already have a computer. The truth is, it is technically possible to host websites yourself at home, but it's really hard and nearly impossible for a beginner to do it right. To understand why, let's first look at what a web host is. When someone visits a website, they're grabbing files off of a remote server called a web host. But in reality, the picture is nowhere near as simple as this. There can be dozens, hundreds, or even thousands of visitors per second on a busy website. Some of those visitors are automated systems that are deliberately trying to hack the web host to crash or take over the websites that it hosts, to steal passwords, and to do other nasty things. And because of how the web is built, there could be many computers in between the two that change how the signals are routed. Your personal computer isn't set up for all this because it doesn't have to be. Instead, most web developers today pay someone else to host their sites remotely. A beginning web developer can easily find a web host that gives them all they need, both in terms of storage and security, for under $10 per month, or even for free. Through such a web host, you get a lot of things that probably aren't on your computer at home. First of all, a professionally managed commercial web host is always on. Well, it might reboot a few times a year, but it's set up to reboot so quickly that your visitors will barely notice, if at all. A commercial web host has a static Internet Protocol, or IP number. That means that other computers reliably know how to find it. It's also set up to work with something called Domain Name Services, or DNS, so visitors can reach it by typing, for example, example.com, instead of a string of numbers. A commercial web host has lots of specialized software, including database servers, programming language interpreters, and, of course, web servers. Your home computer might have some of this software, but it's not really optimized to serve websites. A commercial web host has its servers in a room with good physical security and an uninterruptible power supply. They're used to dealing with malicious hackers and have backup processes to keep your data safe. Most importantly, all of this is overseen by professionals with years or even decades of experience doing nothing but managing web hosts. When you go looking for a web host, you'll be faced with an overwhelming barrage of options. The web hosting market is diverse and competitive, with thousands of companies and configurations. As a beginning web developer, you can dismiss two kinds of web host right from the start. A co-located web host is where you set up your own server exactly the way you want it, and then you put it in someone else's building. This requires deep server maintenance skills, plus hundreds or even thousands of US dollars a month. A dedicated server is where you rent an entire physical machine in a data center. You don't own the machine, but it's still expensive and gives you far more resources than you'll need. Much cheaper is a virtual private server, or VPS, which typically costs between about 10 and 50 US dollars a month. A VPS uses software tricks to make it look like you're the administrator of an entire server. But in reality, you're sharing the hardware with other customers, and that's where the virtual part comes in. I personally use a VPS because it gives me lots of freedom, including, quite honestly, the freedom to screw up badly. Finally, we come to shared servers, which are easy to find for under 10 US dollars a month, or sometimes you can even find them for free. They're more restrictive than VPSs, though, and that might be okay at first, but you'll probably find that you can't do some things that you want, and the problem is access. On a shared server, you might not be able to use your own programs to connect through SSH and SFTP. Instead, you'll have to use their web-based programs, which aren't as flexible. Shared web hosts often only let you put files in your home directory, and that can be a problem when you want to install software. Sometimes you'll need to change server settings, for example, to increase the permitted size of file attachments. And, unfortunately, it's hard to tell whether something like that is permitted on a shared server until you start using it. All web hosts differ in the kind and amount of resources you can use. Bandwidth and storage space are two of the big ones, although if you're just practicing web development, these limits almost certainly won't bother you. The same goes for the company's estimate of how often the server will go down. More relevant to you will be such matters as whether you can use your own domain name, and if you also get email service. The good news is that many web hosts offer a free or cheap trial period. So I'd recommend not worrying too much about which web host you choose. Just start with a monthly plan to avoid getting locked into a long-term contract right away. That'll give you time to figure out how to get what you need at a price that you can afford.